National Atheist Day? Let's find out what we mean by that. Now, whether or not people call it National Atheist Day or not, that's just something I'm throwing out to you. So let's look at what the Bible says in one verse in Psalm 14, verse 1. Let's read it there in our copy of the King James Bible, Law of Swords. It says, "The fool has said in his heart, there is no God. They are corrupt. They have done abominable works. There is none that doeth good." None. None whatsoever. Well, tonight, I want to take a little bit of our time and look at three things about a fool. Number one, I want to look at the conscience of a fool. Number two, I want to look at the character of a fool. And number three, I want to look at the conduct of a fool. Now, I think that most people have heard the word fool recently about that song that came out, the pants on the ground thing, looking like a fool and everything. Well, guys, let me tell you something. The fools aren't just the guys that walk around with pants on the ground. The fools are the ones that are in our seminaries.
That's right.
In our universities.
Amen.
In our school system, in our homes, and even in our churches.
Yep.
That are daring and saying, God is dead. There is no God. That is just a myth. It's just something to let us feel good inside.
Amen.
I'm telling you, folks, let's see, we've got 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11 youth here tonight, including the baby.
Yeah.
Now, guys, now I want you to think about this. That's 11 youth tonight, right?
Yep.
If we could get 9 more in here, maybe some of you adults could pretend to be young at heart, at least. Anyway, all right, now, guys, think about this. If we had 20 youth in here tonight, let me tell you something. According to national statistics from all across the country, when these 20 youth get into the first year of college, who of you in here tonight is planning? I know the baby can't raise his hand, but he can Google and gaga. But anyway, how many of you guys are planning to go to college? Anybody? Every one of them. The guys are like, you put your hands down. I'm telling you here right now. Because I know it happened to my wife. This ain't just something I've read, guys. I'm telling you. My wife, what was it? Had a psychology course?
Philosophy.
Philosophy. Okay, philosophy. You may not take philosophy, but in her class, the first day of class, the professor said, does anybody in this room believe in God? And you know what? She's taking a course on philosophy. What does God have to do with philosophy? Well, if you, now folks, think about it, philosophy is how you view things,
right?
If you believe in God, that should, and I know what I'm saying should, have a lot to do with how you view life.
Right.
And you know what? Out of that whole class, how many people did you have in your class?
30.
30. Out of 30 youth in college, the first year, one stood out. One said, I believe in God. One of them. That was her right there. My wife. Now, the other 29 students just sat there. Thought they were petrified. They were scared. They didn't want to cause a scene. Now, that professor said, all right, miss, your assignment this semester, your project is to write a paper explaining why you believe there is a God to convince all of us. And the rest of you, 29, your assignment is to write a paper explaining why there is no God. Now, here's the thing, guys, my beloved. After the break, whenever the class got out, there was a bunch of them students out there standing around, and they were all saying, how in the world am I going to write a paper about denying God when I believe that he's real?
Mm-hmm.
I tell you what they were. They were cowardly Christians.
Yeah.
They were Sunday Christians.
Yeah.
They were Christians
right.
That just went to church. They were people that just went to church
yeah.
And believed in God, but they were too scared to stand up when the rubber met the road.
Yeah, right.
Now, you youth, let me tell you something. The way the national trend is right now at this moment in which you and I live, the year of our Lord, you reach high school, a group of 20 kids that go to church, 17 will deny their faith in the first year of college. 17, 18, 19, 20. You three stand up. If we had 20 kids tonight, statistics say that 17 would deny their faith and 3 would keep their faith. You sit down. What? Guys, what are you going to do when they tell you there is no God? You going to stand in your faith? I hope you do. What are you going to say when they say that you come from a monkey? If you got your pants on the ground, you might just play on the leash there. No. Guys, what I'm telling you is this. My beloved, at this church, they have a water.
That's right.
They have the Bible.
Amen.
They have a preacher that preaches the Bible.
Amen.
They have a Sunday school that teaches the Bible.
Amen.
They get their outings. They'll get their trips. They'll get caravans. They'll even get pizza. But the thing that they get every time God speaks first of all is the word of the living God. Believe whatever you want, there will be dire eternal